That was Crash. That was Afternoons and Coffee Spoons. The next track coming up is And you know, people used to ask me, so what did you not, were you unable to think of words for the song? And I always thought, you know, probably it doesn't look great if, in fact, I couldn't think of words. But so I came up with an explanation for interviews, and I said, well, you know, of course I could have put words in there, but I chose not to because less was more in this case. The real story is that when I wrote the demo for this track, I couldn't think of words for the chorus, but I just passed the demo around to the various band members and said, listen, learn the arrangement and I'll put some lyrics in later. And when they heard the track, they said, oh no, you can't put in lyrics. It sounds great like it is. So I was very pleased about that. And I think it kind of works in an odd way. It's kind of like you hear a verse and then the comes in, and it kind of sounds like I'm reflecting on what's just been said with the So I actually thought it worked out nicely. But that's the real story, is that I really couldn't think of words, in fact. But it turned out for the best. Then less is more sometimes. We also had we were making videos back then, of course. That was de rigueur. I guess it still is. And Alan Reed, our keyboard player, came up with every single video concept we had for quite some time. Didn't get paid for it, but she did come up with the concepts, and then they would be produced by someone else. So I was very lucky to have someone that was visually oriented, because I am not that guy. I write the songs, but as far as what might go well image-wise, I'm not the guy to ask. So I was very fortunate to have Ellen Reed, our keyboard player, was really good at that stuff, and she would come up with ideas. Snap, snap, snap. And you know, the other thing about this song is that I get all kinds of flack from people in radio because they just have a hard time announcing the song. Here comes Is That the Way You Say It by Crash Test Dummies. And I really hadn't planned on making anyone's life difficult, but I thought it would be fun to name the song because so many songs are just the lyric to the chorus, right? And in this case, the lyric to the chorus was not a lyric at all, so that was my thinking there. And there we go. There it is. And this same song became a huge single for us. We had a big hit with Superman's song in Canada, but not really anywhere else. And whereas this song, it got big in America, starting in Atlanta, Georgia. And the guy who ran Arista Records, Clive Davis, a notorious man in the music industry, and I'll say that in a good way. Once he saw that it was doing well in Georgia, he committed to putting money and people and time into us. And all of a sudden, at every gig we were at, someone from the record label would show up and be very interested and report back to the president. So they really put us through the ringer, as it were. It's a good ringer to be in, mind you. But I've never been so busy in my life. And I'm very grateful for that.
Thanks for watching Behind the Vinyl. We have got a ton more episodes available to you. Your favorite artists with your favorite stories. And here's the thing, we're updating Behind the Vinyl all the time. So if you want to stay up to date on that, simply subscribe by clicking right up here. And you can do us a huge favor by sharing some Behind the Vinyls on your socials. Thanks.